After the Gallic campaign, Attila felt unusually tired for him. He was 56 years old. His hair began to turn grey, unpleasant nosebleeds became more frequent, to which he had paid little attention before. His eldest son Elik is almost 40 years old. Attila suddenly decided that he needed to announce his will. Of course, he will live for many more years, but he must begin now to prepare his sons for the future. They don't understand all of his ideas yet. True, he did not have time to talk with them much, but better late than never. He still has time. Attila spread a map on the table and began to think. For the unity of the empire, it which must develop as a union of autonomous formations. Otherwise, it is absolutely impossible to direct these immense territories. Elik will be the federal emperor. Wanges, with his great experience, will help him. Besides, he is his former teacher. Elik knows the great steppe well, but understands little about the Roman and Germanic worlds. That is why Attila made him participate in his war in the west. Elik was happy to reach the last western sea. Then, like Attila, he would have to travel a lot in the immense empire. Ernak, his younger son, will rule Gaul, Italy and other territories belonging to the Western Roman Empire. In order to govern these territories successfully, he must receive a Greco-Roman formation. That is why he can be helped by Edecon, a warrior of the steppes. The advantage of Edecon is that, while fully aware of the traditions of the Great Steppe, he possesses the strict spirit of the innate engineer. It is predicted that Ernak will have a brilliant offspring, so he will Elik's successor as the federal emperor. Gizem, who has a Gepid blood, will reign over the Balkans. He was assisted by Orestes, a native of Pannonia, who brilliantly managed the Balkan territories occupied during the war with the Eastern Roman Empire. Certainly, King Arderic will also help his nephew. The other present possessions of the Eastern Roman Empire will then be added to this part of the empire. Uzantor will govern Germany and Central Europe from the Oder to the Dnieper. Dengizic will rule over the Dnieper's territories to the Volga, the Ural and Siberia. Emzar will rule the Caucasian steppes on the eastern regions of the empire. All these parts of the empire will in their turn be the federations of the autonomous states, peoples and tribes. Will take a lot of work to make this political system work. He must finish this great war faster than the previous one. Time is cruelly lacking to carry out all his projects. But he's already done a lot. The Huns, after a few centuries of anarchy, have lost many imperial traditions. Fortunately, they kept intact their military organization, their Tang-graced religion and respect for the main laws of Modern Khan. But until Attila, for decades, the Khan's Huns were satisfied with the honorable title of Roman generals and the corresponding pay. Several princes had the title of officer. The other Huns served, often without permission of their Khans and princes, as mercenaries among the Romans. Oros and Attila made great efforts to reunite the Huns and recreate the empire over the new territories. Now the Northern Empire is as strong as ever. It is believed that it will exist for a long time. But a vague uneasiness grips Attila's heart. The warriors of the steppes only recognize sovereigns who can prove by their actions that Tangra is favorable to them. Attila has been recognized by them for a long time. But in the steppes there are many ambitious knights of noble royal and princely families. Will his sons succeed in keeping power over all the warlike vassals? If not, the steppe will again be plunged into anarchy. Then will inevitably appear a strong king who will found a new empire of the steppes. that he will probably be a cruel conqueror. Attila puts the card in the middle of the table and orders his guard to open the door. Enter his sons Elik, Uzuntor and Dengizik with the titles of Khans or Princes and the closest companions. Wunjiz, Orestes and Edikon. The Emperor invites them to sit down. Today we will discuss the future of our empire and the world. Julia exclaims, "You are appointed future Vice Emperor of the Balkans." Orestes smiles, "We can say that." Attila moves on to the final stage of the realization of his union between the Romans and the Huns. Let us say to the Romans' final submission. "My dear, do not sigh. We have discussed this issue 1,000 times. Attila understands that his future great empire will necessarily be Roman-Hunnic. The Romans and Huns are two peoples with strong imperial traditions whose cultures happily complement each other. The Huns will dominate the armed forces and the Romans in administration. Economy and commerce. It is true that the Huns do not even strike their own currency. And the Romans have lost their warrior value. Attila is preparing to invade Italy. Now our properties near Patavium will be on the road to my army. I will strengthen our private guard to protect them well. It will be better if your father stays in one of his villas under the pretext of illness and does not leave for Ravenna or Rome. The Northern, Western and Eastern empires will soon be united into the Great Union.